Coach Ryan, you guys were dominant today here at the Eastern Michigan Open. A lot of true freshmen out there looked just amazing, you know, with Stieber. Hunter Stieber looked amazing. And then DMS, he's a redshirt freshman. And then, you know, other guys that really stepped up. Andrew Campbelltown lost in the finals, but I mean, he looked phenomenal. But what are your thoughts on today's tournament?
One of my favorite things about today, I have a new favorite city. My new favorite city is Monroeville.
Monroeville?
Yeah, Monroeville.
Three in a row.
Yeah. You know, it's early. It's November 6th. It's about getting matches in. It's about learning what you need to do to win. It's about understanding that you're not entitled to wins at this level. And I think some of our guys really need to learn that. Come ready to battle. They're young. They're used to dominating in high school. Most of them are three or four times state champs. They used to walk on the mat and doing what they want to somebody. And now people are fighting back. And it's learning that expect them to fight back. It's hard. It's hard to be the best. But overall, excited about the group. They gel together. They like each other. They want to do great things as a group. So back to the drawing board, back to the wrestling room, and a lot of work to be done.
With when you look at the performance of, you know, Hunter Stieber, gets put on his back,
yeah,
and he comes back. What do you think it says about Hunter?
It's just, I'm not sure you can teach that. You know, I think that he just understands. He's such a competitor. You know, when he's up 4-1, as you pointed out, he's up 4-1. He's in the midst of a takedown to go up 6-1. Instead, kid rolls him through. That's 2-3, so it's 5-4. No facial expressions. No panic. Get off your back and do the job. You're at work. You're at work, and while you're at work, you get the job done. So, and he's just impressive. He's impressive. His brother's impressive, and they're great leaders for us. You know, having guys like that in your room, you know, that rubs off on people. So we're excited about the year. Obviously, a good start to the year. We learned a lot, and that's why we came here. We came to learn about a lot of the weight classes, and we did.
When you look at guys like Derek Garcia at 165 yeah. pounds taking a loss, and then Andrew yeah. Campbelltown taking a loss, yeah. what do you think? What are you going to learn about those guys in the next couple weeks?
Well, first and foremost, Derek is a competitor who is not used to feeling what he feels out there. When you have a two-year hiatus with recovering from injuries, you're not going to be where you used to be, and it's just a tremendous amount of work. I mean, go back in the room and do the work. If you do the work, you're going to be a stud, no doubt about it. So he's just not used to it. He's frustrated right now. But we'll get back in there and do it. Campbelltown, I think in high school, you can, not that it's ever okay, but you can take a mental break or two. And here you can't. There's no mental breaks. You take a mental break, you're on your belly, the guys get your arm behind your back, and the next thing you know, you're fighting for your life. So he'll learn that. He will learn that there are absolutely, the margin of error is so small at this level, and he'll learn to adapt to that. So, you know, you got to throw freshmen in the lineup. You know, we have, five in the finals. These are the type of freshmen you want to put in there. So that's why we're wrestling them all.
Being young as you guys are, what do you think the guys are going to think of a Big Ten schedule? I mean, it is an absolute grind.
It's a grind. You know, it's just, let's focus on one day at a time. Let's get better. Focus on improving. Focus on effort. It's not focused so much on winning and losing. The effort. How much effort did you give? And every single match we lost, for the most part, we got outworked in those matches. The matches that we won, we outworked our opponents. So it's just understanding the level of work that's required. You know, a lot of these guys come in and they're used to winning under a certain set of rules. Here's how I've won. Here are the rules that I follow to win wrestling matches. You know what? There's a new set of rules now. And either you adapt to them or you get used to getting beat. And we're not going to accept adapting to their way of thinking how to win wrestling matches. So, you know, overall, really excited, obviously. Excited about this group. They're young, they're tough, and they want to be good. So.
You guys moving forward next week, I believe yeah. you got Hershey duels, right?
Yeah.
What do you think you guys are, what's the goals as a dual team this year?
Well, just fight, you know, just fight. You know, just fight so hard. You know, we talk about, you know, if there's a grandma in the audience, an aunt, an uncle, who has never seen wrestling, and they come for their first time, at the end of the tournament, if we grab all the grandmas, all the aunts, all the uncles, and we set them down, and we said, you tell me who cares about wrestling, they should pick you. They should. You don't need a keen eye. You don't need to be a college coach for 20 years. You don't need to be watching high school wrestling for 15, 20 years to pick out someone who cares about winning and losing, who cares about what they're doing. And if we show how much we care, we got a lot of talent. If these guys, if the general fan can sense, you know, by the effort how much they care, we're going to win a lot of wrestling matches. And that's the focus this year, just to fight.
All right, last thing, I'll let you off the hook. You guys have been absolutely dominating the recruiting trail. You've been beating it up. Yeah. I mean, the guys you've been bringing in, I look at Intermat every week and there's a new top 20 guy going to Ohio State. How are you sustaining that and bringing those guys in like that?
You know, I think right now we're at the stage where people want to be with us and we're able to pick up really good people that love wrestling, that want to be great for less money than we used to. I mean, it's that simple. To grab the number of recruits we have, it's simple math. You got 9.9. How many are you going to get on them? And it's where we need to be. I mean, it's absolutely where we need to be. So we'll bring in a couple more this year, a couple more the next year, and then this group should be a group that hopefully does great things.
All right, I will see you in Hershey next week. Good luck next week, Coach.
Sounds good. Thanks.